basswood when it's dried out. You see the inside, the vibe of it. It's a cambium layer that we're looking for here. And you can make it as thick, like that one over there, or as thin as you want, based on how much fiber you're going in there. But
the women, again, it was that with the women's job. So, for everyone who just came, my name is Arana. Are you done? Okay, I'm Arana. This is Elise and this is Sparrow. And Sparrow studied with the Native American teacher, so she's bringing us that perspective. Elise is going to bring us the perspective of...
In the workshop that I took at the Common Ground Fair in Maine, I took it from a family who's been really living off of acorns as a staple for quite a few years. And he said that and I haven't looked it up, but the tannins are equal in white oaks and red oaks. And that there's a chemical component in the white oaks that make it less bitter to our taste. So I haven't researched that, but...
Same with theirs, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
He has even a chart. This is a great book, if anyone wants to look through it. He gives a lot of information on acorns, and he gives a chart where it kind of says the percentage of tannins. I think he does somewhere. And he claims that there isn't that much difference. My own personal... Oh, did you finish?
Yeah.
My own personal experience, though, is that white acorns are just way faster and way easier. Whichever method I do, it's just way, way shorter with the white acorns. And with the red oak acorns, they come out great, but I have to have a lot more patience, and it just takes a lot longer. And I think because I started with the white oaks, you know, I forget that. And when I go to the red oaks, I'm like, oh my God, you know, I'm like, I'm never boiling them again. I waste too much energy. I can change the water too many times, or I've got to let it sit for a while.